अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू आवर इस्लामिक सेशन। इन द लास्ट सेशन वी हैव कंक्लूडेड आवर यूनिट चैप्टर 1 प्रॉफिट्स इन इस्लाम। वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द पिलर्स ऑफ फेथ, वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द प्रॉफिट्स हु वर सेंट टू ऑल नेशंस, वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट द नेम्स ऑफ द प्रॉफिट्स मेंशनड इन द कुरान, एंड वी हैव ऑल्सो लर्नड अबाउट मुहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम, द लास्ट एंड द फाइनल मैसेंजर। Today we shall begin with a new lesson, Unit 8, Chapter 2, Prophets are the best of mankind. This is the name of the lesson. Our lesson objective is to learn and understand more about prophets. So the first subtopic in this lesson is all prophets were human beings. So let's get started. Although the prophets were noble and pious role models, they were all human beings. Means the prophets and messengers were righteous in deeds, they were good in character, and they were ideal men. But they were all human beings. They were all human beings like us. They were neither divine. Divine means someone who's like God or godlike, nor they were angels or jinns. As these prophets were so pious, noble and righteous, that it gives us an opportunity to think that were they really human beings? Yes, isn't it, children? Because these prophets, they had such a high character. But they were all ordinary people like us. So it becomes difficult for us to believe that how ordinary people can be so righteous, can be so pious. Because we human beings are a statue of mistakes, and day and night we keep committing sins. But it's been confirmed here that they were like us. They were human beings. They were ordinary people. Like us, every prophet was born to a mother and father, except Isa alayhi salam, who had no mother, and he was born to Maryam alayhi salam, and Adam alayhi salam, who had neither a mother nor a father. As we all know, he was created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the heavens. Indeed, we all are created by Allah. Adam alayhi salam was created in the heavens. Now some prophets had brothers, like we know Prophet Musa alayhi salam. His brother was Prophet Harun alayhi salam. Also Ismail alayhi salam and Ishaq alayhi salam, they were both brothers and they were prophets too. Now many other prophets got married and had children, like Adam alayhi salam. As we all know, he got married and his two sons were Habil and Qabil. We have learnt about their story in earlier grades. And he also had two daughters. Who? Adam alayhi salam. Then Nuh alayhi salam. We know about his son who did not believe in Allah, and then he was drowned in the flood, in the great flood. Then Ibrahim alayhi salam, Lut alayhi salam, Yaqub alayhi salam, Ismail alayhi salam, Ishaq alayhi salam, Yusuf alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam, Dawood alayhi salam, Sulaiman alayhi salam, Zakariya alayhi salam, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam, and many many others. All of them were married and they had children. Now although all these prophets and messengers were ordinary people, they were common people like us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them special qualities. What special qualities? Let's see. Like high morals. High morals, it is the inner understanding of right and wrong, to understand what's right and what's wrong. Then manners. They had good manners. They had attitude, positive attitude. They were honest. means they were truthful, they were patient, they were tolerant, they were faithful, and they were honorable people, respected people. They never committed major sins and shameful actions or crime. They didn't do evil deeds. Major sins: lying, robbery, murder, then backbiting. All these are major sins. So these people, they never did any major sin or evil deeds. Now some of the prophets had a long lifespan. They lived for many, many years. Like Nuh alayhi salam, he lived for 950 years. Just imagine, 950 years. These days it's difficult to cross 100 also. But he had such a long life. Even Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, he lived for more than 200 years. And other prophets died much younger than that. Such as Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he became a prophet at the age of 40 and he died at the age of 63 years. Now Prophet Isa alaihi salam was the only prophet who is yet to die. He didn't die. Then where is he? As we all know, he was raised in the heavens by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He didn't die, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised him in the heavens. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send him back on the earth before the day of judgment in order to end the evil of Dajjal. Isa alayhi salam will confirm Islam as the true and final religion of God. He will prevail over all evil people and powers. Means, he will prove more powerful and supreme over evil people. And when is this going to happen? Yes, before the day of judgment. When the Dajjal will come, all evil will be spread in the entire world. So Isa alayhi salam will come and end all the evil in this world. Now our next subtopic in this lesson is all prophets were men. Now here the question arises, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose only men to be prophets? Why he didn't choose women, or why he didn't choose angels or any other divine creature to become prophets? Now Allah created we human beings to stay on this planet. That is the reason he chose human beings to become prophets. If Allah would have created angels, and if he would have caused angels to stay on this planet, then he would have sent angels as prophets. But since we human beings live on the earth, he sent human beings as prophets. Now among human beings, why men and why not women? Now Allah has created men and women differently. So the roles and responsibilities of men and women are different. They are different but equally important. Now Allah didn't choose women to become prophets. Doesn't mean women are of less importance or women are of no importance. It's Allah's wisdom and He knows everything well. Now being a prophet or a messenger was not an easy task. It was a very serious responsibility, a very difficult task, which required a great deal of perseverance and strength. Strength? Physical strength. To be strong physically. And what is perseverance? Not giving up. Not giving up on anything. Not to quit. Or persistence in achieving something despite of delay and difficulty. So being a prophet required all these qualities. Now some prophets got killed, like Prophet Zakaria alayhi salam and Yahya alayhi salam, who was Prophet Isa alayhi salam's cousin. Other were put in prison for years and years, like we know about Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam, who was the son of Prophet Yaqub alayhi salam. For so many years he was put into prison. Almost all the prophets and messengers were persecuted and harassed. Persecuted means they were oppressed and ill-treated. They were not treated properly. They were victimized. Like Nuh alayhi salam, he was troubled so much by his community. Then Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, as we all know, he was thrown in such a big fire. And Prophet Yunus alayhi salam, Prophet Musa alayhi salam, Prophet Lut alayhi salam, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam, and many others, all of them were troubled and tortured by the people. Therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in his glorious wisdom, he is all-knowing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is all-knowing. He is al-alimu, he is al-hakimu. His wisdom and knowledge encompasses everything. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala carefully chose those who were the best suited to serve as prophets. Those who were best suited to become prophets and messengers, Allah chose them. Allah also stated that he selected only men to be prophets and messengers. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Yusuf, "We have not sent before you but men from among the people of the towns to whom we sent revelations." So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making it clear over here that he chose men to become prophets. However, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose certain faithful women, to play major historical roles. Now, who were those women? Asiya alayhi salam, the wife of Pharaoh, who claimed himself to be God. And Asiya alayhi salam was a true believer. Then Maryam alayhi salam, who was a single mother, she gave birth to Isa alayhi salam. And even the mother of Maryam alayhi salam. We also know about Hajra, the wife of Ibrahim alayhi salam, and the mother of Ismail alayhi salam. She was left alone in the desert of Makkah. Then many other sahabiyat. Khadija radhiyallahu anha, the wife of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, she gave so many sacrifices and helped the spread of Islam, isn't it? And there were many other women who were chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to serve Islam. And all of them gave many sacrifices for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These women were not prophets, but they were great women of faith. The next subtopic in this lesson is, how did they become prophets? How did they receive the message of prophethood? How did the prophets come to know that they were selected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to serve Islam? Let's see. There are two ways in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reached out to his prophets. The first way was by sending an angel to them. For example, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam received the message of prophethood from the angel Jibreel alayhi salam in the cave of Hira. As we all know, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to go and sit in the cave of Hira for months and months. He used to reflect and ponder on Allah's creation even before he became a prophet. So there only he received the first revelation from the Quran through angel Jibreel alayhi salam. In other times, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke directly to his close prophets. For example, Prophet Musa alayhi salam went to a desert valley where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to him directly. This is the reason why he is called Kalamullah in Islam. This is the reason why Musa alayhi salam is called Kalamullah, or the one to whom Allah spoke. Kalam means to speak. Allah, to speak to Allah. Now Allah's prophets and messengers received the same basic message. What was the same basic message? That Allah is only true creator of the universe. He is the only one true God. Thus Allah is the only one worthy of complete obedience and worship. Now Adam alayhi salam, Lut alayhi salam, Nuh alayhi salam, Musa, Isa, Zakaria, Yahya, Ishaq alayhi salam, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam, and all of them brought the same message to their people. What same message? Worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the only one true creator. Obey his commands and not to associate any partners with him. None of these prophets and messengers claimed themselves to be divine or godlike, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed some of them with miracles, and they were blessed with so many special qualities. But still, these prophets and messengers, they never claimed themselves to be divine in any manner, in any way. And they all conveyed and taught their people a true belief in one God, one Creator. Now, to your left hand side on this page, there is an image. It is of Mount Jabalun Nur, or Mount of Light. On the top of this mountain, the cave of Hira is located. It is near Makkah. In the cave of Hira, where Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam received the first revelation from the Holy Quran through Jibreel alayhi salam. And to the right side image, it is the Sinai Desert. Desert valley where Musa alayhi salam received the message of prophethood from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's see some more clear images. This is the Sinai Desert. This is Mount Jabalun Nur, and on the top of it, the cave of Hira or Ghare Hira is located. This is the cave of Hira. So children, we have completed 3 subtopics of this lesson today. All prophets were human beings. All prophets were men. And how did they become prophets? The remaining part of this lesson will complete in the next session.